In 2010, the Singing Men of Texas embarked on a God-sized task to take the life-saving gospel of Jesus Christ to the people of Ukraine. What began as a single trip has turned into an epic series of mission journeys that God has used to draw nearly 15,000 people to Himself. 2012 was the most ambitious year yet for the Singing Men, with two trips to Ukraine scheduled in April and September. What God did in the hearts of thousands of people during these 23 days of missions can only be described as supernatural. As we had in previous years, we partnered with evangelist Michael Gott, who for decades has been used of God to do an incredible work in Ukraine. With an anointed gift of evangelism, as well as a team of Ukrainian nationals already on the ground, and relationships with local churches already well established, Michael Gott was just the man God had for this incredible job. The April trip kicked off with a packed house at First Baptist Church Odessa, and in that first concert we saw over 1,000 in attendance and 547 decisions for Christ. The next day in Nikolaev, at one of the city's largest concert halls, 1,700 people packed into a 1,500-seat auditorium, and there were 757 decisions for Christ that night. And it only got better from there. Over the course of 2 weeks, we sang to nearly 9,000 people and saw 3,998 decisions registered for Christ. But God was not through with us in Ukraine. In September, the men returned for another round of evangelistic concerts, and again, night after night, people packed the venues and came to Christ. In one city, we returned to a church that was destroyed by fire just days before we were to sing there in 2010. Now, with the help of over $70,000 raised by the Singing Men, Michael Gott, and our mission partners, the church has been rebuilt and it was bursting at the seams when we returned to present two concerts to a combined audience of nearly 2,000 people, 667 of whom made decisions for Christ. In Zaporozhye, a 5,000-seat sports arena built for the purpose of advancing the communist agenda reverberated with the message of the gospel. And in that one concert, over 1,100 responded to Christ. Between the April and September trips, God used the Singing Men of Texas to draw over 8,300 people to Himself. The Lord has given the Singing Men an incredibly unique platform for presenting the gospel to the people of Ukraine. And with millions still out there who need to hear the message of the cross, the combined forces of all six chapters of the Singing Men of Texas will return to Ukraine once again in the spring of 2015, this time specifically targeting the largest arenas across the nation. As many as 20,000 people will hear the gospel. And if the Lord blesses as He has in previous trips, we could expect to see over 40% of those make decisions for Christ. May Christians everywhere who hear this testimony have awakened within them a fire to reach the world for Christ. If the Great Commission is the great omission of your life, then it is time to step outside the walls of the church and reach out across the street and around the world. When God leads, He provides. All we must do is obey and say, "Here I am, Lord, send me."